solve the equation 6x squared minus 2x minus 20 equal to 0 algebraically and sketch the graph of the equation. So we're going to graph the, sorry, first we're going to solve this algebraically and also use the method that we're going to use to sketch the graph. So the method that we're going to do is solving by completing of squares. So let me write the equation, which is a quadratic equation. So you've got 6x squared minus 2x minus 20 is equal to 0. Okay, so the first thing that I would like to do is you can reduce it. I can factor out the 6. So let me factor out a 6. So if you factor out a 6, you will have x squared minus, this is, I want to get 2x here. So I'm going, if I want to factor out a 6, I can write 2x over 6 minus 20 over 6 is equal to 0. So if you think backwards, if you expand 6 times x squared is 6x squared, 6 times minus 2 sixth is minus 2. And 6 times minus 20 over 6 is minus 20. So this, I'll keep 6 out, so this is nothing but x squared minus x over 3 or 1/3 x minus 10 over 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so what will happen next? So I'm going to do completing squares. So this is 6 times x squared minus 1/3 x. Now to complete the square, what we do is you do the half of negative 1/3, which is negative 1/6. So I'm adding negative 1/6 the whole squared. So what we do is you take the half of the coefficient of x and then square it. So half of negative 1/3 is 1/6, and then square it. So I have to immediately add negative 1/6 the whole squared minus 10/3, which is already there, is equal to 0. So let me change color. So this is equal to 6 times, so this has become a perfect square of x minus 1/6 the whole squared. This negative 1/6 squared is same as this is plus, sorry, you have to take over here. So you have added minus 1/6 squared, so you have to take away 1/6 here. Okay, so here what will happen is this is minus 1 out of 36 minus 10 out of 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so what we did is I have squared this and then taken away this. So this is a squ you added this number and then taken away the same number. So this is 6 times x minus 1/6 the whole squared minus 1 out of 36. I want to get a 36 here in the denominator, so I have to multiply by 12. So if you multiply both the numerator and denominator by 12, so this is nothing but 120 over 36 equal to 0. So this is 6 times x minus 1/6 the whole squared minus 121 over 36 equal to 0. Okay, so this is 6 times this is x minus 1/6 the whole squared, and 121 is 11 squared and 36 is 6 squared, so that is 11 over 6 the whole squared is equal to 0. So I forgot to tell you one thing. Now as we are doing two things together, this form, this first from the first equation, from the quadratic equation, you can tell the y-intercept. Okay, so what is y-intercept? If you have learned graphing quadratics, y-intercept is where x is equal to 0. I'll come to that later. So I'll call this is the y-intercept form. So I want you to think, from this I can directly see what's the y-intercept. Okay, so I'll only write y-intercept this at this stage. I'll talk about it later. This is, we're going to write this as the vertex form. From this form I can say what's the vertex. So this method that we're doing is helpful to do solving algebraically and also graphing it using the same method. So I'll talk about why this is called the vertex form. Okay, so I'll leave it there and I want you to just think. Okay, so this is 6 times. This is difference of two squares using a squared minus b squared. So let me write the formula. The formula is a squared minus b squared is a plus b times a minus b. So using that formula, you can compare your a with x minus 1/6 and your b with 11/6. So using that formula, I can write this as x minus 1/6 plus 11/6 times x minus 1/6 minus 11/6 is equal to 0. So this is nothing but x times, this becomes x, this is minus 1/6 plus 11/6 is plus 10/6 times x minus 12/6 is equal to 0. So this is nothing but x times x plus, this is halving both of them, this is 5/3 times x minus 2 is equal to 0. And this I call the x-intercept form. So these, to graph a parabola, you need the x-intercept, the y-intercept, and the parabola. So let us start from the x-intercept. Okay, so we are solving it. So let us finish the solving and then we'll go to the graphing part. So now you can divide both sides by 6. So if you divide both sides by 6, you can say x plus 5/3 times x minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, so x to, when this is 0, this you have set, you have to set this equal to 0. So let me write. So this steps, this means, this implies x minus, x plus 5/3 is 0, or x, you can also write and. So in both this situation, this form will become 0. So x has to be minus 5/3 or x is equal to 2. So writing in a mixed number, so minus 5/3 is minus 1/2 or x is equal to 2. So these are, this is the x-intercept or the roots. Okay, so solving, so we have solved the equation, quadratic equation. So when solving means for which values of x is this equation going to be 0. So here algebraically the answer is x is equal to minus 5/3. X is minus 5/3. You can put this minus 5/3 in this equation. You'll get 0, or x is equal to 2. So let us come to the graphical part now. I told you that the y-intercept is 0. Sorry, y-intercept you get when x is equal to 0. So let me talk about that. Let me use a different color. So y-intercept is when, let me write like this. So y-intercept is when x is equal to 0. So if you put x is equal to 0, this will become 0, this will become 0. So what's the y-intercept? So you can say y-intercept is, intercept is y is equal to 20. I'll show this on a calculator later on. So just by looking at this, you can see that the y-intercept is negative 20, sorry. The y-intercept is negative 20. Because this becomes 0, this becomes 0. So what is left is negative 20. Okay. Now to get the vertex, what you have to say is, if you look at this form, I'll do one step more. So this, when you distribute this x, so this becomes x 6 times x minus 1/6 the whole squared minus 121. So when you times this by 121 over 36, this will become 121 over 6. So this can be simplified to x 6 times x minus 1/6 the whole squared minus 6 goes in 120, 121 20 times. So this is So I'll rewrite this. So this is x times 6 times x minus 1 sixth the whole squared minus 20 whole 1 sixth. So the vertex from this equation, I can say the vertex is, so what has happened to the parabola? So if you think about, if you know how to graph parabola, so the basic parabola has got a stretch factor of 6. This 6 tells me it is stretched 6 times, so it has become leaner or thinner 6 times, pulled up, it has gone 1 sixth to the right. The basic parabola has been stretched, you can see in any order, it has been stretched 6 times, it has moved 1 sixth to the, so your vertex has, will become 1 sixth, and it has gone minus 20 and 1 sixth down, so the vertex would be minus 20 whole 1 sixth. To be exact, okay, and these are your x-intercepts. So this is the x-intercept. So your x-intercepts are these roots. So which is x is minus 1 2/3 or 2. So let us graph this. So this is all we need to graph a parabola. So this is only a sketch. So this is my y-axis, and this is my x-axis. Okay, so this is your y-axis and this is your x-axis. This is only a sketch. So this is a parabola. So I'll draw, this is a parabola. Okay, so your x-intercept, so this is minus 1 2/3. And this is your 2. This is not drawn to scale. This is minus 20. Your y-intercept is minus 20. And this point, this is 1/6, okay, so this is 1/6, comma, and this point is minus 20 whole 1/6. So let us check this on a calculator. So I already typed, okay, let me delete this. So let me type in this equation. The equation is 6x squared minus 2x minus 20. I had to make the scale. I had to go, let me check my scale. Minus 10 to 10 is fine. So let me make it minus 5 to 5. Okay. And I've gone up to 22. Your y has gone up to 22. So let me go up to 5. Okay. And see. This is a parabola. So just to check your g-sol, your root, is this is minus 1 2/3. This is minus 1 2/3. And the next root is 2. Your y-intercept is minus 20, and your minimum is your vertex, which is, this is nothing but 1/6, and this is minus 20 and 1/6. Hopefully this video has been helpful. I'll maybe making few more videos on this topic.